Here I'll show you how to make an origami phoenix. It's a little tricky and I highly recommend you learn how to make a crane before trying this fold. We'll start by folding this square in half to make a rectangle. Notice I folded the pattern side in. Give this a good crease and then unfold. Now we're going to take these top corners and fold them down and in towards the middle, just like you were making an airplane. Once you have that, flip this over and fold the slanted ends down and in towards the middle. Now we're going to take the flaps from behind and unfold them. When we do this correctly, you'll see that there's a square or diamond shape in the center there. Okay, now flip this over. We're going to take each slanted edge and fold it in towards the middle crease. This next step is going to be very similar to the last. Using this part right here as a point of reference, we're going to fold in towards the middle line. You'll notice that the crease doesn't go past the middle of this square section. Now let's repeat that on the other side. Now we're going to take this diamond shape here and fold it backwards on itself to make a triangle shape. By now we've got a few folds on top of each other, so make sure you do a really good job of creasing the paper. Okay, from here we're going to fold this thing in half. Now we're going to fold this flap down to form a triangle. Pay attention to this area here because it's extra thick and you don't want it to tear. Give that a good crease and then unfold it. Next, you'll slide a finger inside to invert the crease. And then squash this flap down into a square or diamond shape. Next, we're going to petal fold this, just like you would when you're making a crane or bird base. Fold the open edge in towards the middle and do the same on the other side. Now we're going to open this up and invert the creases and fold in, just like you were making a bird base. This is one of the trickier parts, and again, I highly recommend you learn how to make a crane or the bird base before trying to make this phoenix. Now I'm going to flip this over and repeat the exact same steps on the other side. Okay, we'll squash that flat. And now from the bottom of this kite or diamond shape, we're going to fold in towards the middle on both sides. If you already know how to make an origami crane, this should look very familiar to you. Now let's flip this over and do the same on the other side. This portion right here will become the head and neck of the bird. These flaps will be our wings, and this flap our tail. Gently inverse this crease by opening it slightly and pushing up to form the neck of our bird. When you reach your desired angle, squash the paper flat. Now we're going to open this up in the middle and push down to form the head. And now we'll do another inside reverse fold to change the angle of this tail. Just like with the neck, find the angle that you desire and then squash it flat. And now just a couple details and we'll be done. Let's open these wings up here by folding them down. Then you can unfold the tail a little bit and pop it in the middle so that it stays open. And there's your phoenix.